Good morning, coaches. For those who don't know me, no, ako si Coach Potit De Vera, right, currently coach nga ng TIP and then also a TV analyst sa MPBL, no? And a little background lang, no? I started in the coaching world nung 97. I started out PBL juniors actually. And then also I've been a long time assistant coaches to head coaches early in their careers, no? In a chronological order, no? I've been an assistant in the early years of Jamaica Rin, unang-una, then Binky Favis, and then to Eric Gonzalez sa PCU juniors niya, and then from there to Coach Nash Rosella sa Batangas Blades niya. At that time, I was his first ever assistant coach for his first ever head coaching job sa MBA, sa Pangasinan Waves. And then to the early years ni Coach Goldwin Monteverde, who's now in NU. And then to Coach Coy Banal sa FEU, where pinalitan ko lang si Coach Eric doon. Sub ako doon. And then started off doon, no, from there. And then now, what I'm going to share right now is just really an overall view, no? Maraming magagandang topics that we will be encountering tong next few weeks, no, dito sa AIA series natin. And I'm here to really just share a thing that is really close to my heart, no? What is a coach? It's really a startup, ano, for the week to come. For the weeks to come, this would be a good startup para sa atin. Not really X and O's, but really pertaining to the spirit and the heart of a coach. And without further ado, no, I'll start na. I'll share the screen. I'll share the screen already. And then, teka, okay. I'll just share the screen. Okay. Just chat. Sabihan nyo lang ako kung may problema sa reception nyo, no? But you should be able to see right now is what is a coach na slide. Makikita nyo bang lahat? Okay naman. No problem at all. Wala pang problema. Okay pa lahat. Okay. So let's begin na lang. What is a coach? You can actually replace the word coach with teacher, with a leader, mentor, to a certain extent sa mga ibang pinuntahan namin, even a pastor, no? You can replace the word coach with those words, kasi as you will see as we go through this session, it's just one and the same as well. No, it pertains to the same thing. So what is a coach? What's in the word? So we can actually define a word with its origin, no? Kung saan nagsimula yung word, sometimes dahil lang sa origin na yon, we can already give a meaningful definition of the word. So before we continue on, just for a few minutes, huh, for a minute lang, do sa hindi pa nila alam o hindi pa na research ano, I just like to ask you, tingin niyo, hula niyo, saan nanggaling yung word na coach? Sige, kahit i-type nyo lang sa chat box, okay na yon. Type nyo lang sa chat box, where do you think the word coach came from? Kung alam nyo na yung sagot dahil narinig nyo na tong talk or na-google nyo na before, okay, huwag nyo nang sagutin dahil alam nyo na eh. But for those na hindi pa alam, any guesses where the word coach came from? Kahit sa chat box na lang. Di ko lang makita yung chat box natin. Nasaan na yun? Ah, okay. Anyone? Naririnig niyo ba ako? Okay. So, pwede niyo ano? Any guesses? Coach Jun, any guesses? Unmute kita. Unmute kita. Coach Jun, any guesses kung saan galing ang word? Hindi, hula lang.
Teacher.
Teacher, okay. Anyone, pwede niyong i-unmute sarili niyo just to give your thoughts, no? Before I continue on, where the word coach came from?
Model.
Coach Carlos, tingin niyo, hula.
A leader.
Leader. Okay. Last one, last one. Coach Mark Guardiano, any guesses?
Guide, coach, guide.
Guide, okay. Okay. Sige, tuloy ko na lang to, ha. Okay. Actually, the word coach Teka ha, pa tayo mag-share. Ayun. The word coach galing sa isang kalesa, ano ba pwede pang Tagalog ng cart? Na kalesa, no? It came from the word 16th century Hungarian cart, no? Isa lang siyang kalesa ng mga panahon na 'yan, mga lumang panahon pa. That is where the word coach came from. Paano? Itong mga Hungarian carts na to came from a small village of cooks. Now, it's a small village in Hungary na siguro nung time nila sila ang pinakasikat when it comes to paggawa ng mga kalesa nito. And these are the typical kalesa. Yung mga nakikita niyong kalesa ngayon, these are the actual carts. These are the actual coaches na nasa museum nila ngayon. So these are a piece of their history. And kaya nga coach, because of the name of the village, Cox. Now, these were superior wagons. So, magaganda. Sabaga, nung panahon nila, yan yung mga Mercedes-Benz. Yan ang mga BMW. Yan ang mga Rolls-Royce na mga kalesa nung panahon na yan. And with that, ang gumagamit niyan, dahil mamahalin yung mga kalesang yan, these were really used by royalty. No? Mga hari, mga gobernador, duchess, dukes. So royalty lang ang nakakagamit nito just because of the superior quality coming from this small village in Hungary. Now, baka sabihin nyo kasi fake news. Eh. Alam nyo na uso fake news. So ito yung mapa ng Hungary, you can see. And a little dot there is the near Budapest is Cox. So yan. And then on your right sa screen nyo, yan yung kanilang seal. City seal siguro nila yan. Ano? Yan ang seal ng bayan nila. So this is actual place, ano? And in the 16th century, they make the best coaches for royalty. So with this, now this brief history lesson, we have already uncovered, no? Really uncovered such a beautiful and meaningful definition of a coach. And what is this? Diba, coaches from that period sa Cox were used to transport royalty to their chosen destination. Biray mo, with this origin, with this definition of the original word ng coach, kung saan galing yung word na coach, we can already, it already connotes three things that are very important. No, as a job ng isang coach. Number one, it talks about who you are responsible for. How you see your players. With the definition, with the origin of the word coach, ang bit-bit pala dapat natin are not just players, not players who waste our time, but they are actually royalty. And if they are royalty, as coaches, these players must be treated as such. Sabihin, napaka-importante na ang pagtingin natin sa mga players natin. Hindi lang player na magagaling, but really as important as royalty. The second that we can derive from the origin of the word coach is already kung ano ang trabaho natin. Ang trabaho natin hindi lang gumaling ang players, but actually is to bring them somewhere. What is this somewhere? Maybe a chosen destination? Maybe a destination that they need to go to. But definitely, it is not about basketball. It is about a destination for these royalties. And thirdly, it is how you will bring them. How you will, ika nga, paano ka makikitungo? Yung pakikitungo mo sa mga royalty na to. And just like yung mga kalesa noong panahon yon, gagamitin sila ng royalty. We as coaches, the question is, how will we be used? Paano tayo magpapagamit sa mga players natin? So, again, another, just I'll give you 2 minutes. Coach Ryan, kung pwede, okay lang. Guys, coaches, pwede mong i-unmute ang sarili ninyo or chat it up. Could you please give me adjectives right now? Give me kahit single word adjectives in how to describe these coaches na nakikita nyo in front of you right now. Sige, go. Coaches.
Okay. Coach.
The floor is yours. Ano?
Coach Potit, Sir, Coach Jimmy po to. Siguro yung nakikita ko dyan, yung mga coaches na nandyan.
Ano lang, Coach? Sila yung bigyan mo lang ako ng adjective.
Experienced person.
Okay. I want you to give me an adjective dito sa itong picture ng dalawang kalesang nakikita nyo sa screen ninyo. Bigyan nyo ako ng adjective that best describe itong mga kalesang nakikita nyo ngayon sa harap ninyo. Anyone, coaches? O Coach Ryan, pumili ka na lang magsasalita.
Coach, elegante, coach.
Elegante, yan. Good, elegant. Sige. Keep it rolling, coaches. Hindi ako magpapatuloy kung hindi kayo sasagot.
Matibay, coach.
Oh. 2 points na si Coach June. Yung iba.
Coach Potit, meron sa... May mga nag-chat eh.
Okay. Right now, dahil naka-share screen kasi ako, I won't be able to access yung sa chat.
Ito.
Papakin na lang. Sige.
Special. Oh, sir, ito, may nakalagay. Special, hardworking, sincere.
Strong, coach, strong.
Matibay, sturdy, strong, okay? Nakikita nyo ba yung madetalye? Nakikita nyo yung mga design ng mga kalesa? Mga madetalye, magaganda yung detalye?
Coach Putit, yung pong ano...
Yes, coach.
Sige, Coach Dave, yes.
More on design po siya. Quality.
Quality yung design. Oh, quality yung design. Oh. De kalidad. Elegante.
Yes, Coach. Yes, Coach.
Sige, Coach Rai, paki-post na lang. Ay, paki... Yes? Okay. Coach Ryan, paki-mute na sila. Okay. Yung mga words na ginamit, special, strong, yung detalye, napaka-elegante, quality, kitang-kita mo yung quality, no? And then other words, no? Marami pang tayong makikita na pwedeng gamiting adjectives as you see these words, as these, you see these, coaches na nakikita nyo sa screens nyo. Bakit ganyang kaganda kaya yan? It's because, number one, sino ba ang sasakay dyan? Diba? Royalty nga eh. Mga hari, reyna. No? At the most, mga lords pa ang tawag ng mga iba dyan. So, hindi pwedeng basta-basta lang yung kalesang ibibigay sa kanila at sasakyan nila. So, the villagers, the manufacturers of these coaches, kailangan maganda. So, in a way, no, these coaches were wonderfully made. Kasi nga, unang-una, ang kailangan nila dyan makita is yung kalidad para sa hari. Diba? Para mo sinabi yung presidente ng Pilipinas, sasakay ng tricycle araw-araw. Diba? Hindi naman pwede. No, very unfitting for the position. And to think about it, diba? Ganyan din tayo mga coaches. For us, for us to match the quality and the significance ng ating mga players, we have to prepare ourselves also. We have to prepare ourselves with much thought, with much quality. Excellently prepared din dapat tayo. Why? Because yan ang very fitting for our players. Only if we see our players as royalty. Just like how the original coaches were made for royalty. And if it is royalty, ang gagamit sa atin, may royalty, kung ang mga gagamit sa atin, mga tao na ang tingin natin mga importante sa mundong ito, then as coaches, we have to prepare ourselves first. And this already encompasses everything. Imagine nyo, ano? Imagine nyo just by uncovering, just by trying to go back to the past and figure out yung origin word na coach, it already gives you a very clear job description, a very clear definition of what a basketball coach is, what a teacher is, diba? What a mentor, a leader is. It starts foremost with, again, how you see the people you are going to lead, to teach, to coach. Hindi basta-basta. Kung saan mo si anong job description, anong gagawin mo, anong purpose mo, to bring them somewhere. These important people, you have to bring them somewhere. How? Papagamit ka. Alam naman yung mga royalty ang sasakyan ng coaches. No, it's the other way around. Yung mga royalty, yung mga pasahero, ang sasakay sa coaches. Yung mga coaches ang sasakyan ng mga players natin. Not the other way around. We will not piggyback ride on our players, but they will be the ones to be on our backs. So with the main history class lang, ang dami na nating napulot na napakaganda, manapakalalim actually about what a coach is. But so what is a coach? These 7 items, though strong in itself, can stand by themselves, but these 7 items of what is a coach that we will be talking about in depth more, they can be intertwined. So baka parang Lego, pag pinagdikit-dikit mo yung mga yan, mas matibay lalo yung coaching na mangyayari. Yung coach na haharap sa players, magiging elegante, magiging sturdy, magiging matibay. Oops, sorry, excuse me. Magiging matibay, of quality, if you put them together. But at the same time, each and every one of it, by itself, matibay na rin. But if you put them together, mas maganda for a coach. So let's begin. Coaches help turn dreams into reality. No, lalo na ngayon, very timely. No? Marami ako na-experience now na mga mahal sa buhay na nasawi, no? Na namatay ng just because of this virus. No? And ang pinakamalungkot dito sa mga panahon ito is namamatay sila na walang mahal sa buhay sa tabi nila. Dahil bawal eh. Bawal ma-infect, bawal mahawa. So kahit yung mga mahal sa buhay, wala sa deathbed ng mga taong ito when they die. And one of the few things, when you are in your deathbed, no, mamatay ka na, nakahiga ka na, is mga pagsisisi, no, mga babalikan mo sa buhay mo na hindi mo nagawa. These are one of the things na iisipin mo. Though not the only thing, but one of the things na iisipin mo, yung mga regrets mo sa buhay. And this is where coaches come in. Actually, mas malala pa is ang regrets is much more painful for the living. Diba? Yung mga mamamatay na, yes, they are regretting some things sa buhay nilang di nagawa, hindi naabot, pero mas masakit para sa buhay kasi araw-araw mararamdaman nila yung regret na yun. And we can lessen these instances as coaches for the players by helping them. Helping them go to somewhere where they want to be. But as coaches, paano natin malalaman? No? How do we know? How can we know where to bring them? Where to bring our players? Or sometimes, hindi nga alam ng mga bata kung saan pupunta. So how can we discover kung saan dapat sila pumunta? Kung saan dapat natin silang dalhin? And one of these things, siyempre, yung background checks. No? Once you get your players in your team, diba, hindi mo naman basta-basta tatanggapin lang without knowing or I mean, matatapos yung time mo with him, working with him for his lifetime, na hindi mo man lang alam kung ano pinanggalingan, pamilya. And then, of course, intel, no? Yung mga aalamin mo. May mga bagay na alamin ka sa kanila. And with this information, you can process. And then, of course, you can already summarize or conclude somewhat kung saan dapat dalhin itong batang ito. Ito, one of the things na challenge for me, because this pertains actually to life outside the court, small talks. Ako kasi kahit even outside the court, when I'm with my players, paminsan basketball pa rin talaga ang bukang bibig ko, and that's a challenge for me. Because when you're off the court, okay, try to talk about off-court things, try to talk about non-basketball things, no? As silly as it may seem, no? Yung mga small talks na yan, it reveals more about our players. And parang recently lang, ano, I just figured out, no? I just learned about silly talks and silly questions. Like, kunyari, tatanong mo daw sa player na, if you were stranded on an island, sino ang gusto mong makasama at bakit? Nakakatawa mga tanong, no? Kung if you were to be someone else for one day, who would you be and bakit? And nakakatuwa lang just because these are silly questions and these are fun questions for the players. Hindi mabigat. Kung titignan ng players, hindi mabigat ang mga tanong na to. So they will answer without apprehension. They will answer with their guards down. But their answers actually will reveal a lot about them. And these are very helpful things for us to use to process so that we would understand where to bring them also. And of course, it boils down to how you regard your players. If you regard them as royalty, if you regard them as people who are very important to you, then of course, you will and you must find out things about them that will help them in the future. Diba? Imagine mo may kalesa ka at ang sumakay sa'yo si Michael Jordan. Hindi mo ba kakausapin? Diba? Lalo ngayon, napapanahon yung Last Dance. Diba? What if si Kobe Bryant sumakay sa taxi mo? Hindi mo ba susubukan kausapin, alamin, kilalanin? Bakit? Kasi importanteng tao siya, di ba? And that's how it is also with our players. Sumakay ang player sa coach natin, sumakay ang player sa kalesa natin, di ba? Alamin natin kung sino siya. Dahil excited tayo, dahil kilala to, sikat tong taong to, importante tong taong to. Though these are your players, importante pa rin sila. Coaches serve. I remember, no, isang storya of a bossy boss, di ba? You have two people. No? One is a boss, bossy, walang ginawa kundi mag-utos. Diba? Mag-utos, kuha mo ako nito, bili mo ako niyan, pakipulot ito, bit-bitin mo to, trabahuhin mo to. And the other one, siya yung mas maraming ginagawa para sa tauhan niya. Diba? Napakasimple. I think you've heard it already, no? Yung mga ganitong storya. Kanino mas mapapamahal yung tauhan? Doon sa taong palautos o doon sa taong palatrabaho? And of course, the answer is hindi doon sa palautos for sure. Diba? Though paminsan, just because of position, baka sundan mo yung palautos. But at the end of the day, yung puso ng mga bata, yung mga puso ng players, mga puso ng tatrabaho sa kanya, wala yung puso doon. It's on the other person. No? Yung tao na tingin nila nasa taas but bumababa sa kanilang level to serve them. Trabahuhin yung mga dapat trabahuhin kasama niya. Hindi for them but with them. And even in the Bible, it also says about a lot. About coaches, ano? Sa Bible, meron pala about coaches. It's about serving. Now here sa Mark 9, verse 35. And then a lot, no? You could see a lot sa Bible verses then about how to serve. It is not about being the boss, but it's about serving the people under you or the people you're responsible for. One of the stories na gusto ko lang i-share is sa amin, when I got to TIP noong 2012, ayan si TH, testament ni TH yan. TH, sabi mo kung cooking ako, ha, pwede mo ako i-rebuke dito, harap-harapan. Pero when I got to TIP, noong 2012, one of the first things I changed was yung sistema ng mga rookie at veterans. Alam naman natin sa basketball team, pag rookie ka, balagoong ka kaagad. No? And when you're a rookie, you serve. You serve the veterans. You serve the team. And that's one of the things that I intentionally changed, no, sa sistema sa TIP. Ika nga, noong umpisa, nahirapan din yung mga veterano. But the point was, kayong mga veterano ang maninilbihan sa team na to. Kayong mga veterano ang maninilbihan sa mga bata, sa mga baguhan, sa ating mga rookies. Why is this important for me? Because when your leaders serve the rookies, at pagdating sa court, nagsalita ang mga leaders na ayusin mo to, o makinig ka, o execute mo to, o hindi mo inaayos ang sarili mo, these rookies will listen. Why will they listen? Eh kasi si kuya, nagtatrabaho para sa akin. Dapat kong pakinggan. And it really works. You know, these rookies, no, yung pa makapalang mukha sa simula, no, ayaw pa rin makinig, but eventually they will catch on. And even the veterans na nahihirapan mag-adjust sa sistemang yun about serving the rookies, eventually they catch on. And what happens also is these rookies, diba, these rookies, they can't wait for their time to be the leaders. Because now they see that when they're the leader, they serve the team. Diba dati, ang ngayon, hanggang ngayon, diba, ang mga rookie, ang inisip, pag ako naging veterano, babawi ako sa mga rookies. And that's actually one of the things that I really want to gun, no, sa, dito sa TIP dumating ako. Rather, ang gusto ko sana is, pag ako naging leader, diba, aasikasuhin ko rin itong mga bata. Kasi when I was a rookie, diba, nakuha, nahuli ng mga veterano ang aking respeto. And that is the more important thing. And this idea was actually, kung makikita mo yung mga who's familiar with the Montessori education system, diba ganun yun eh, yung nursery, kinder, prep, magkakasama yan sa isang classroom. And yung daughter ko, nung she was nursery, inaasikaso siya ng mga kinder and ng mga prep, no? And then eventually, it impacted her to the point na sinabi niya na she can't wait to be prep para siya naman daw ang mag-aalaga sa mga little girls. And that's the same. That's the same with what we are doing sa TIP. And yeah, no, nahihirapan sila to start dahil because ang kultura natin dito, yung mga bagito ang babalagongin eh, no? So, but it really works in the long run because really it takes the respect of the rookies, no? And pushes them to serve the team more, actually. Kahit yung mga veterano, hindi nagsasabi. Hindi nagsasabi na trabahuhin mo to, rookie. They do it. The rookies do it. Why? Because nakikita nila na everybody is working. So they do their part without even being told. Therefore, coaches, no, should and must serve. Pa simple lang naman eh. Again, we go back to the origin of the word coach. Diba? Yung pasahero ang sasakay. Hindi yung pasahero ang sasakyan. And right here, as coaches, yung mga players natin, ang mga pasahero natin. And they will be the ones riding our backs. So, paminsan nakakalimutan lang din ng makaramihan yan. That the players are here not for us, but we are here for the players. Coaches exemplify. Actually, it's a cliche for us, ano? Coaches exemplify. Just because, number one, we know for a fact na coaches dapat, no? Actions speak louder than words. Alam na natin yan. But how does that really work? And how does that really affect the players? Diba? And it is not only on the court na you have to show as coaches yung sinasabi mo, no? But actually, it is the non-verbal actions. What do I mean non-verbal? Are non-significant actions. Ito yung mga pang-araw-araw mong kinikilos. Yung mga tingin mong maliliit na bagay na kinikilos mo. These are the actual things na binabasa sa atin ng mga players natin. How we respond to situations, how matters small or big. No? Pinag-aaralan ng mga players yan. How we respond during games, during practices. Pinag-aaralan ng players natin yan. Whether we like it or not. Every day, every second of our life as coaches, we are walking examples for them. It is not only the big moments but actually the more important lessons are learned in your small moments. Those yung hindi mo napapansin o hindi mo akalain na naturuan mo pala sila, maraming pagkakataon yan. Body language, speech, attitude natin, how, no matter how insignificant it may seem for us as coaches, yun yung mga binabasa ng mga players natin. And in connection with coaches exemplify, are also coaches, you look for those teachable moments. Now, marami sa atin, paminsan nga, again, because we feel na hindi naman importante yung ginawa natin, so hindi natin iniisip o binabaliwala natin yung impact na meron yun sa players natin. A good example would be, makapag nagbibiroan ng mga players, no, mga panahon natin ito, no, how players talk about, a good example ng one time sa TIP was, hindi pa nagsisimula ang practice, nagtitipon-tipon lang sa court ng mga players. No? Naglolokohan sila dahil yung isang player namin na medyo bigo ang love life. No? Ewan ko kung brinekan ba siya o hindi siya sinagot ng babaeng liniligawan niya. But the players, no, trying to comfort them, it was a ano naman, out of good nature, out of goodwill naman, yung mga payo ng players. Pero ang payo nila, marami naman babae dyan. Yeah, I remember. Nag-aaway pala sila ng girlfriend niya. No? And ang payo ng mga kakampi niya was, maraming ano, maraming babae pa dyan. Maraming isda sa dagat. Ganyan, nabibiruan sila and everything. But when I heard that, no, initial response ko was to talk to them agad, no, about it. Na kinorek ko. Corny na kung corny. But kung girlfriend mo siya at nag-aaway lang kayo, the first instinct should not be to look for other girls. No? Hindi maghanap ka ng ibagong isda. No? But to fix things. And sinabi ko yun sa mga players as they were joking around. Why? Because I think for me, that was already a teachable moment. No? I mean, those small things. Marami yan. Marami yan. Things that come out of your mouth. The fact na lumay-up ka, tinira ka ng kalaban. Diba? Tapos, babalikan mo yung players, sabi mo, ano, babakla-bakla ka, ano, bawian mo. These are things na maliit, bababaw sa atin, di ba? Out of instinct, di ba? Out of our heart, puso nga, ika nga, di ba? But, hindi natin akalain, napakalaking bagay pala nun, malalim pala sa kanya yun, na pag tinira ko, babawian ko rin pala, kasi mas lalaki yun. Remember coaches, especially those who are coaching men, no? Yung boys basketball or men's basketball, remember, your players will one day be husbands. These players of yours will one day be fathers. Your examples right now, knowing and unknowingly, your examples right now will also define them as husbands and fathers. So, wag niyong maliitin yung mga small teachable moments. If you see a teachable moment, do not delay. Pasukan mo kaagad kung kailangan. Kasi baka yung lesson na maituro mo, mawala ang impact if you delay. So if you see a teachable moment, intercede, act already, teach. A good story na i-share ko is one of our players. I have two stories actually about players. No? May isa akong player, while we were practicing, itong player kong ito may girlfriend na nabuntis, so may anak na siya doon sa girlfriend niya. And while we were practicing one day, no, may napansin kaming mga babaeng umakyat sa gym, no, to watch the practice. And may kutub ako kung sino yung pinapanood ng mga babae. And it was this player na may girlfriend na may anak na. And during the practice, nasa malayo yung player, no, at malapit dun sa babae, sumigaw ako. No? Oh, sabi ko, oh, Joshua, sabi ko, oh, kamusta yung girlfriend at anak mo? Sige, tawa na lahat ng players, ano? Tawanan talaga lahat. Alaskado si Joshua. But at the end, no, yung babae bumaba, nahiya at bumaba. At that time, I really thought na yun yung message na kailangan maparating, hindi lang doon sa player, pati doon sa babae. No? Letting the girl, no, na may girlfriend, na may anak na to, no? Wag na siyang pumorma. And for the player, kay Joshua, wag na siya mag-isip ng iba pang mali, no? And those were funny teachable moments, but they got the message. Another story would be mga player, lalo sa college, mga love life talaga ang problema. And another player of mine na may asawa at anak na, no? And I heard na merong siyang ibang babae on the side. Nalaman ng babae, nalaman ng girlfriend. And at that time, sinimplihan ko yung player. Sabi ko na, kamusta ba ang love life mo? Which, alam niya na may alam na ako. And yun, nagkakamutulo. Tapos nahihiya ako noon. No? And then I just ask him, sino ba ang importante sa'yo? Ay, hindi kita huhusgahan. But, sino ang gusto mong mawala? Your girlfriend o yung bagong babae? And when he said na ayaw niyang mawala yung girlfriend niya na anak, nanay ng kanyang anak, diba? And then I told him, di malinaw naman pala. So I think dapat mawala yung isa. And just by doing that, no, pinaalam ko sa players also, no, what I will not tolerate and what I will tolerate. Coach, basketball ka lang, dami mo naman pinakialaman, marriage counselor ka pa, love life ka pa. No. That's part of it eh. Because I don't see a basketball player. I see a father, I see a husband. And these are teachable moments. Not only what you tackle, no, but not only what you tolerate, but also what you do not allow and what you do not tolerate. Again, sa point number two natin, interceding now. If you delay, that means to the players, ang message mo sa players is, okay kay coach. But if you act quickly, ang message sa player, hindi pwede kay coach. It's that important. What you make important soon, what you make important now, will be important to them also. So it's also as important yung mga hindi mo kinikilusan. Things that you tolerate, things that you will allow. You will just let it happen na hindi ka umaksyon. These are already signs sa players na, ah, okay kay coach. So these are teachable moments. But coaches recognize the power of their position. Itong item na to, this is closest to my heart.
Dad.
Closest to my heart. How many of you dito, no, nag-run na ng basketball camps, no, sa mga bata, and you've tried talking to them, no, and even to their parents, nakakatuwa nga, because ito mga batang ito nagpupunta sa camp mo, ang unang reklamo ng mga parents sa kanila, hindi sila mautusan sa bahay, no, o mga tamad sa bahay, ni mag-ayos ng kwarto, hindi ko mapagawa, coach, di ba? But this same exact kid, as a coach, sabihin mo sa kanya, hindi kita palalaruin bukas. Pag nalaman ko sa nanay mo na hindi ka naglilinis ng kwarto, sa tingin nyo, ano gagawin ng batang yan? Of course, this kid will clean his room. This same kid na siguro 5 years nang patuloy sinasabihan ng nanay na maglinis ng kwarto, hirap na hirap yung nanay. Pero ikaw, isang beses mo palang nakilala yung bata at sinabi mo yung magic words, hindi ka maglalaro pag di mo linis ang kwarto mo. Guess what will happen? Magiging masipag yung bata. And this is important for us coaches to realize that you hold power. You are one of the most powerful people sa buhay ng mga players. Hindi nga players to ng team mo. These are players sa basketball camp lang. I have parents even telling me, coach, ano ba't sinabi mo sa mga anak namin, no? Na sa camp pa lang na to, naging mabuti yung mga anak namin sa bahay, mga nauutusan, mga maaga na gumising, kumakain na ng gulay. May mga ganong storya, nakakatuwa, no? Pero, paminsan we forget that behind that story is a lesson that we as coaches, we are the one of the most powerful people sa buhay ng mga batang ito. So, it's very important what you say, what you show to these kids. It goes back to being aware and being intentional. Bakit? Kasi nga, royalty to mga to. If you see these players as someone important, then you will be careful, tama? If you were around President Duterte right now, di mo ba iisipin ang mga ikikilos mo sa paligid niya? It's the same with our players. But sadly, no, I mean, kahit ako minsan nakakalimot, na sadly, we sometimes forget that these players are so important that I have to check and I have to watch out what I say and do. It goes back again to how you regard. This is a reoccurring theme sa talk na to is how you regard the players as royalty or just common people. I always remember na nabanggit sa akin to ng dad ko, no, na it is not the big things, no, it's the small things that when you put together they become big. And that's one part of my coaching philosophies, no, that the small things when you put them together they amount to something big. So it's not, don't look for the big things, make sure that every small thing is of quality, intentional, and very memorable to our players. Just because when you put all these small memories with these all small experiences together for the players, they become one big thing. And this big thing will materialize when they are husbands and fathers. Coaches know it is a journey. Kapit na tayong matapos sa journey ito. Itong talk kong ito. And it is how we respond to challenges, really, that defines our walk in life. Our perseverance sa mga problemang hinaharap natin as a person, not just as a coach, but as a person, defines our walk in life. And again, we go back to the other points na minention ko na kanina. Our players are always secretly watching us, studying us, learning from us as to how we react, how we respond to the challenges thrown sa buhay natin. And if we have this mentality that life is a journey, I think mas magiging persevering tayo. Kasi hindi total failure ang isang araw. If you look at it, na marami pang araw na darating. But of course, you treat life, you treat every day as if it is for your last. But you know at the back of your mind, may bukas pa, may bukas pa. So not everything will be very black, very doomly, no? Ika nga dito, is 10% of life is just what happens. Wala tayong magagawa. And 90% of how you respond to it. And even in the Bible, it says really a lot about perseverance. Imagine mo, pag nakita ng player sa atin that sa mga problema ang pinagdadaanan natin on and off the court, and our players see how we persevere. Yes, we will fail. That's one thing that is for certain. Na as coaches, as people, as a person, we will fail. But it is after we fail that lessons will be learned. After we fail, di ba? Sabaga sa pagbubuhat nga, di ba? Nagbubuhat ka up to failure. But only up to failure. And you do something, an exercise after that failure that makes you stronger. Di ba? It's the same with us in life. Di ba? And we know, if our players see that we persevere and triumph on the next day, then our players will see hope. Anong hope? Hope na para sa kanila, when they fail, it's not the end. And that's very important. As coaches, we'll teach our players na may bukas pa. And someone with hope, and we all know that how strong, how powerful it, hope is sa isang buhay. Pamisan nga, yung mamamatay na, yung may cancer nga, mamamatay na, just because of hope, because of his fighting spirit, no? Nagkaka-miraculously na nabubuhay, natatalo ang cancer, natatalo ang life-threatening diseases just because of hope. And that is what we carry also as coaches for our players, showing them that there is always hope. Imagine mo kung ikaw yung coach na natalo, tas ang how you act, parang end of the world na. Eh, paano pa sa player? Diba? So, try to imagine that. I just share with you a short video. It's a scene from Rocky. Kausap niya yung anak niya. So, I'll just show you the video right now.
Coach Potit, walang audio.
Walang audio?
Yeah, mahina. Or parang wala kami naririnig.
Ah, wala? Oh, teka lang. Ah. Sorry. Coach Ryan, paano ba natin nalakasan yung volume last time, yesterday? Ah, alam ko na. Wait. Share. Coach, sorry ah, technical difficulty ah. Teka lang, ayusin ko lang yung share screen. Si Coach Ryan, nasaan? Coach Ryan. Nawala. Boss Ryan. Nawala si Boss Ryan. Ano? Teka, ayusin ko lang yung...
Paano yung ginawa mo kahapon?
Wala daw volume eh. Ano ba ginawa natin
sa share,
kahapon?
Sa share, tapos optimize for...
Okay, teka. Ah, yun. Ah, okay. Sorry. Okay. Sige, ito coaches. Sorry.
You as a favor for me.
You think I'm the last thing I ever
think? Doesn't it bother you in that? Do you think that's...
You ain't gonna believe this.
Yeah, Coach, just need time.
Well, you used to fit right here. I'd hold you up to say to your mother, this kid's gonna be the best kid in the world. This kid's gonna be somebody better than anybody ever knew. And you grew up good and wonderful. It was great just watching. Every day was like a privilege. Then the time come for you to be your own man and take on the world, and you did. But somewhere along the line, you changed. You stopped being you. You let people stick a finger in your face and tell you you're no good. And when things got hard, you started looking for something to blame, like a big shadow. Let me tell you something you already know. The world ain't all sunshine and rainbows. It's a very mean and nasty place, and I don't care how tough you are, it will beat you to your knees and keep you there permanently if you let it. You, me, or nobody is gonna hit as hard as life. But it ain't about how hard you hit. It's about how hard you can get hit and keep moving forward, how much you can take and keep moving forward. That's how winning is done. Now, if you know what you're worth, then go out and get what you're worth. But you got to be willing to take the hits and not pointing fingers saying you ain't where you want to be because of him or her or anybody. Cowards do that, and that ain't you. You're better than that.
Okay. Sorry, coaches. Ah. Okay. Okay. Sorry, coaches. Teka lang. Yun. Okay. So I already transcribed the dialogue ni Rocky doon, and pwede niyo i-screenshot kung gusto niyo, no. But this is a great line. This is just a great scene, no, about how to look life as a journey. Di ba? With your permission nga eh, Coach Jun, with your permission, pwede ko bang i-share ng kaunti ang buhay mo, if it's possible? Okay lang, Coach Jun? Okay. Alam nyo, si Coach Jun, again, he is a coach from Cebu. And ang storya niya, ang background niya, yung anak niyang lalaki got... recruited dito sa La Salzobel. And so one of the things that he did for his family, kasi pati mga anak niyang babae, no, kinuha na rin sa Manila to play. Ang magagaling lahat mga anak niya. So mga coaches na naghahanap ng mga player, no, kaya mga anak ni Coach Jun, magagaling lahat. minigrate niya buong pamilya niya rito sa Manila, knowing how tough and how hard it is for them. No? And it has never been an easy ride for Coach June. Pero for the longest time na nandito siya sa Manila, no, he's been grinding it out every day. And I cannot imagine kung ano ang pinagdadaanan ni Coach June ngayon, no, sa COVID na to, sa lockdown na to. But that is exactly, no, what the players in his perseverance siya sa buhay. And imagine mo if the players ni Coach June and even his children, kita yan sa anak niya, sa tatay nila, how he perseveres. I don't think there's a much better inspiration, motivation para sa mga players at anak ni Coach June kundi sarili niya. And maybe unknowingly na ituturo ni Coach June ito sa kanila. But that is exactly what Rocky is telling us about life. No? It is a journey. It is not a sprint. It is a marathon. And in a marathon, makatapos ka lang, no? No, makatapos ka lang para ka nang nanalo. And that is what is more important. No? Though worldly values, worldly views tell us na kailangan may one, may champion, may first place, may loser, may winner, no. That is what or how the world chooses to view life. But in the end, kahit milyonaryo ka buong buhay mo, katabi mo, mahirap buong buhay niya. At the end, pareho lang naman kayong pantay-pantay sa dulo. And that is life. Life does not need first or last placers. One thing is certain, there is an end. And ito, mga one of the most used cliches din, ano, for us coaches, na trust the process. And that is exactly true, no? If you know that it is only about the process, it's only about the end, it's only about finishing the race and not who goes first or last, then now you are more intent in focusing in finishing the race, and that is your process. And recently lang ano na I added this because I think it gives more meaning to the process, yung purpose. Yes, you might have the process, you might have the game plan. But behind it, what fuels your process? Ano ang nagbibigay ng apoy sa proseso mo? And that is your purpose. It gives more meaning and significance to the process. Perseverance is about hope. You can only persevere if you have hope that if you persevere, things will be better. Kung kaya yung mga nakakalungkot na yung mga kaibigan natin, mga taong kilala natin, o hindi kilala na may suicidal tendencies or nag-suicide, because they lost hope. And when you lose hope, you stop persevering. Because you lost hope and you did not persevere. Why? Because of your view of life. If we teach players that life is about winners and losers, try to imagine half of your players not succeeding sa pangarap nila. What's next for them? And we can only teach hope if we as coaches, we as people, persons, persevere. These are lessons that they will learn from us because they are on our backs and not the other way around. Last 2 points, coaches. Coaches inspire, they bring out the best out of people, of course. Kung hindi ka naniniwala sa player mo, gaganahan ka bang trabahuhin sila? Gaganahan ka bang working with them? If you yourself believe that this guy will not amount to anything, that this guy is not worth your time, if you don't have faith, how can you inspire someone if you don't believe in him? The great debate among coaches, positive reinforcements versus negative reinforcements. I think it's a balance. It's just a delicate balance of both. Yeah. But it starts with the players knowing kung ano ang nasa puso mo when it comes to them. I actually have this talk to play to my players sa TIP, no, to start the season. And sipin nyo na lang merong nagsisleepwalking, ano? Nagsisleepwalking sa cliff, sa dulo ng bundok, nagsisleepwalking. At itong player na to, oh, imagine mo na lang, mahal mo sa buhay, nagsisleepwalking, at naglalakad na siya papunta sa bangin. And you are at a distance. You're at a distance. Hindi mo siya mahawakan. So, ano gagawin mo? Bubulong ka? Bubulong ka ba? Or positive ba yung emotion mo when you try to tell him na, "Hoy, gising na. Mahuhulog ka, gising na." Because of that situation, ba sisigaw ka to the top of your lungs. "Hoy, baka may hoy ka pa. Hoy, gising ka. Mahuhulog ka." Hindi nagising. Hindi pa rin nagigising yung mahal mo sa buhay. Patuloy pa rin naglalakad papunta sa bangin. So now, instead of being from afar, tatakbo ka na. Lalapit ka na sa kanya. Sisigawan mo. Habang tumatakbo ka papunta sa kanya, sumisigaw ka. Tama? Bubulong ka ba? Hindi. Out of very gentle ba ang approach mo as you run to your loved ones na natulog, naglalakad papunta sa bangin? Hindi. You will run with much urgency, with momentum, with a lot of emotions running through you. At sisigaw ka, "Hoy, gumising ka, mahuhulog ka." Hindi pa rin nagising. What do you do next? Lalapit ka na ng husto, hahawakan mo sa balikat. Baka yugyugin mo, "Hoy, gising na, gising na." Ayaw magising, ayaw huminto sa paglalakad papunta sa bangin. What else can you do? Honestly, personally, baka sampaling ko na sa mukha. Pak, pak, "Hoy, gumising ka." I will do everything para magising yung mahal ko sa buhay bago mahulog sa bangin. And after telling this story to the players, this situation to the players, I just tell them, sometimes, baka sampalin ko kayo sa mukha dahil ayaw nyo magising at nasa panganib na kayo. Yung ginagawa nyo sa buhay nyo, ayaw nyo pumasok sa eskwela, palabas-pasok, labas-pasok kayo sa dorm, gabi na kayo umuwi, bumibisyo ka, baka mahulog ko na sa bangin. At because you are very special to me, you are my loved one, do not expect puro positive sa akin. Baka kailangan na kitang sampalin sa mukha, paluin na kita sa puwet para magising ka lang. Kasi ayaw kong mahulog ka sa bangin. That is the negative. Siyempre, alam naman natin positive reinforcements, good job. O, gayahin nyo si ano. Diba? Ang ganda ng ginagawa. Those are positives. And that's very important. But just as important for me is the balance of the negatives, which is also as important. It depends on the situation. But you have to have both sa bulsa mo. Pinag-uusapan namin kahapon ni Boss Ryan na this line, itong buong lockdown, pud-pud na. Hindi ko na nga makita yung writing dahil sa sobrang gamit. Sobrang gamit itong phrase na to dito sa lockdown period na to. Sa mga webinars na pinuntahan natin, na players do not care how much you know until they know how much you care. So important. One of the best, more important cliches sa mundo. And they're right. It's right. Bali, wala. Walang kwenta na matalino ka. Walang kwenta na alam mo ang lahat. To the kid, if they feel that they are not important to you, hindi sila makikinig sa'yo. Baka ikamungki ka pa. Ikasama pa nila na nandiyan ka sa paligid nila. And lastly, coaches have faith. Like I said kanina, it's hard to work with someone that you do not believe personally na may mararating yung tao. O worth your time, worth your effort yung taong to. And that's why faith is important. Faith in someone. Faith in who you work with. Having faith means understanding, having a better perspective na ang buhay mo hindi mo kontrolado. Hindi mo kontrolado karamihan ng mangyayari sa buhay mo. And because of this faith, because of this understanding, mas magiging tolerable, mas magiging manageable ang buhay. And if mas manageable ang buhay because of the fact that you embrace that not everything is in your control, then you manage better what happens in your life. And if you manage better what happens in your life, mas malaki ang tsansa na makaka-respond ka ng tama, mas makaka-respond ka sa tamang oras. And if you do these things, then good job. You've just persevered an obstacle in your life. I believe only people who have faith can understand this perspective na hindi mo kontrolado buhay mo. Ni traffic nga eh, hindi mo kontrolado. Kahit ka, bumili ka pa ng motor para umiwas sa traffic, kahit motor, nata-traffic pa rin.
It's banana lang.
Have you ever met a person na godless? Meaning, walang gino-Diyos. No? It's not even a matter of kung sinong Diyos. It's just a matter of walang kinakatakutan tong taong to. Imagine mo, one day may naglalakad sa harap mo, may itak, walang gino-Diyos, walang kinakatakutan. Tatabi ako, kakatakot eh. Diba? And that goes the same. No? That's a very exaggerated example. But just as deadly is a person without faith, a person without a God. A godless person is someone na is capable of doing anything, everything, anytime to anyone. At yun ang isa sa pinakadelikadong tao sa mundong makakasama mo. In this Bible verse, it's plain and simple. Kung ang ibon nga na alagaan ng Diyos, tayo pa. If this faith of yours tells you that God is in control of your life, then mas mamamanage natin buhay natin. Again, it goes back to that. Kung tayo nga, hindi tayo perfect. Kung tayong tao nga, we as fathers, we as coaches, sons, husbands, whatever, kung tayo hindi tayo perfecto, we know how to give good things to our loved ones. We are not perfect. But even we are not perfect, know how to give love to our loved ones. What more a God with perfect love? About a God with a perfect love for us. And if we understand that fact, everything will be more manageable. Everything will be more persevering. We can persevere a lot of things if we have faith. And a story lang I'd like to share is yung isang mentor ko sa States, no, sa Athletes in Action, si Coach Mo, while watching a basketball game, was approached by an actor, a very famous actor. Na nakilala si Coach Mo because he's been around basketball for a long time. So linapitan siya, Coach Mo, he had a question. This famous actor had a question about life, about the purpose of life, how to go about life. And weeks went on, no, na nagko-communicate sila. And this actor, on one of the conclusion ng kanilang weeks of talking, this famous actor sent a message, no, dito kay Coach Mo, yung one of our mentors sa Athletes in Action, and this is what he said. I get it now. For you to lead, you have to know where you are going. Of course, di ba? And to know where you are going, you have to follow someone great who's been there. It was Denzel Washington na yung kausap ni Coach Mo. And he was preparing at this time in his life, ni Denzel Washington, he was preparing for a role. Book of Eli. He was preparing for this role sa Book of Eli na movie. When he had this conclusion, it's like, how can you go somewhere if you don't have a map? But that is not the complete illustration. The complete illustration is that guy with the map needed someone better, needed someone greater, needed someone who was ahead of him to make the map. And that map napunta sa kamay natin and we are using it. And that is what Denzel concluded sa usapan nila ni Coach Mo. For you to lead, you have to learn to follow someone ahead of you. Basketball-wise, Denzel Washington, na movie rin yan. Basketball-wise, find coaches better than you. Find coaches who are ahead of you to teach you and to mentor you. Like I started, no, tong talk na to, how I made mention of the many coaches I've worked with. For me to get to this point, di ba? Sila yung mga nauna sa akin, na nagturo sa akin, how to get where they are, how to get ahead, how to move forward to where they are, because they are ahead of me. Find coaches. If you remember Coach Paolo Layog, no? We were talking the one day, a few weeks ago, we were talking about looking for coaches to mentor you. Not to tell you to get coffee, not to tell you to drive their cars, not to tell you to get their laundry. I know that's part of it, but diba? They have to mentor you in respect to where you want to go. And that is being a basketball coach. Basketball-wise, be a coach who is ahead of his players, who can drill your players to play basketball the right way. I use the word drill, inspiration to kay Coach Rennie, no? I think who's already here. Coach Rennie used the word drill. Sa Tagalog, ano yung drill? Barena. And ang isang barena, kailan natatapos gamitin ng barena? Kapag yung tornilyo na baon na ng husto sa dingding, sa kahoy, or wherever na kinakabit mo yung tornilyo. Pero yung barena na yon, patuloy ang trabaho ng barena yon until pumasok yung tornilyo doon sa kinakabitan niya. And I think as coaches, that is the purpose of a drill. Patuloy mong ididrill sa player, patuloy ang pagturo ng mga konsepto, ng skills, whatever, execution, until it gets into their heads, until bumaon yung tornilyo sa kaloob-looban ng kanilang ulo, ng kanilang utak, ng kanilang puso. And that is what we need. Coaches who will drill to their players how to play the right way. Sa buhay, be the coach who will exemplify to your players how to live life also the right way. And that's very important. Again, we're not just here for basketball. They are going to be future husbands and fathers. So, more than basketball, we want to show them an example of how to live as a father, how to live as a husband. But, ika nga ni Denzel Washington, who is ahead of us in life? Who is ahead, who is better than us in living the right way? We cannot go to someone lower than us. We cannot go to someone, we cannot learn from someone below us. We cannot learn from someone who is doing the wrong things when we want to find out what the right things are. It's not like pupunta ka, magtatanong ka ng direction sa bulag. A blind leading the blind. Of course not. Diba? That's ridiculous. That's silly. Nakakatawa. So sino ang kilala ninyo? Who can you be? Who can you learn from? Who has lived his life? Who can we learn from? Who has lived his life the right way? A life that God wants him to live. Sino yung kilala nyong yun? Sino kaya ang pwede nyong puntahan para pag-aralan? And sino yung best model mo for this kaya? Maraming tao, yan ang mga tanong sa buhay. Sino ang pwede nilang puntahan para malaman ang sagot sa mga katanungan nila? At ang katanungan nila, it leads to one path. How to live the right way. How to live how God wants me to live. Who is our model? Here in Athletes in Action, maybe we can help you as coaches. More importantly, maybe we can help you, lead you, guide you to who this best model is as a person. So coaches, as we continue to trust the process, try to remember the purpose of this process, the purpose of a coach. We don't just teach basketball. So remember that. That's just part of it. But more importantly, we teach lives. We teach life. We teach how to live the right way through the game of basketball. So as we conclude, no, we'll give you 5 minutes each for each question, Coach Ryan. We will be flashing to you in your breakout groups these questions. Facilitators of each room, you are given 5 minutes lang for each question. Then go on to the next question. Hindi na tayo lalabas pasok for every question. We'll be in the breakout room for 15 to 20 minutes. And every 5 minute intervals, we will discuss each question. And then we'll come back and conclude the talk.
Okay. Yeah. We'll just get to. There's a pre-assigned facilitator per group, so you can take down notes if you want to. So, para mamaya in the big group, mas madaling mag-share. Okay. Starting the group. Now, MJ. Himala, wala ka sa ano ngayon, ha? Pag, lagi, pag tinatawagan ka namin, lagi kang nasa ano, eh.
Saan, coach?
Saan workout ngayon, ha? Nakamute ka, Coach P.
Okay. May ano, may mga similarities na kami ni Coach MJ. Mga mahihilig sa lechon.
Okay.
Marami sa grupo na to.
Saka, gagawa na daw akong YouTube.
Hindi kasama sa Oatmeal Boys yan, eh.
Sa akin sasama yan, sa Sarsa. Sarsa Group. Coach Chico, Coach Jonathan.
Hello po, Coach P.
Nandito na ba lahat? Kayo mag- Coach
wala
Paolo.
Pa.
Macho ah. Coach Paolo,
kaya
macho.
So lahat tayo magkakaroon ng ano, recorded videos nito. Lahat ng participants. Is, I will send the link when it's available.
You
can
okay, Coach.
Coach Boss Ryan, nandito na ba lahat?
Yeah.
18 participants
so.
Total. 18. Ilan ba tayo kanina?
20 kayo eh. 20.
So, dalawa na lang boss, wala?
Probably. Oh, lahat nandito na. Baka okay. Na cut off sila.
Nandito na. So,
wait lang, mute ko lang ulit.
Basta po, Coach.
Sige.
Binati ko daddy mo. Happy birthday.
Okay.
Okay.
I hope the...
May anong greeting. Tapusin muna natin.
Okay na? Sige. Okay na. Okay. Coaches, I hope the breakout sessions, yung apat na napag-usapan, no? Sana naka... Kahit papano, it shed light, no? To encourage you more and to also teach you more, no? To develop you more. No, and I hope na somewhat you can allow or find a way, or I mean allow Athletes in Action to be part of your journey rito as coaches, no, as men, no? Mapuro lalaki naman tayo dito, no? I hope it can be part of your walk also, no, include Athletes in Action sa walk ninyo, sa development nyo as a man, as a coach. But to finish it off lang, a coach once taught me na the only way for one person to know na natuto is kung isinabuhay daw niya, no? And that's very true, no? Even for players, kahit anong turo mo sa player, unless ginawa niya, hindi tayo maniniwalang natuto siya or nakinig siya or naintindihan niya, 'di ba? Ganun lang kasimple. And for us coaches in today's seminar, I hope na may natutunan kayo, and I truly, hopefully, prayerfully want to see na maisabuhay nyo kung ano man yung mga natutunan nyo. Kung may natutunan kayo or wala, personal nyo yan. But if you did learn something, I hope and I pray that you do apply it, isabuhay nyo as early as possible, kasi this is going to be an exciting chapter of your journey as a coach. Will make us better. I'm sure it's going to make you better and not to bring you down. So what you do today, what you do now, is already an important step. There's no pressure to whatever, no? But what you do now is going to be an important step. And one way of figuring out, finding out kung may natutunan ka. Just like to share, no? No, just like to share a story. No, it just happened the other day lang, no. Just talking about, I think, teachable moments, about you teach by telling or showing your players what you allow, what you tolerate, and what you do not. Now, may isa kaming rini-recruit na bata, no, from Mindanao. Ang hilig mag-TikTok, no? I think you napansin niyo naman, halos lahat yata mahilig na mag-TikTok, kahit coaches nagti-TikTok na eh. No? But this particular kid nagti-TikTok, pero nung pinapansin ko, ang mga nagko-comment karamihan bakla. Ang dami nagko-comment sa kanyang bakla, mga bakla yung comments, nagko-comment sa kanya. Sabi ko, pambira to, ginawang negosyo TikTok ah. So, I mean, he's a recruit. No, hindi pa siya TIP player. But I reached out to him, no, message ko talaga siya. Kung nangangalakal ka, hindi ka player, baka hindi ka tugma dito sa TIP. And ora mismo, no, nag-reply yung bata at sinabi, "Coach, ano ba yung maling ginawa niya?" So I told him, no, na may mga nagre-reply sa TikTok mo tapos iniinganyo mo pang suportahan ka. Ano ba talaga ang pakay mo sa mga taong 'yan? Kaibigan mo ba talaga? It turns out nga hindi nga niya kaibigan, ano. Pero kung mag-reply siya sa mga comments ng mga baklang to, I'm not against that, no, but sa basketball, sa tagal natin sa basketball, bakla at basketball player na nagcha-chami-chami, alam mo na eh, di ba? Negosyo 'yan eh. And walang pinauuntong, walang nararating na maganda usually yung samahan na 'yan. And etong batang to probinsyano, tapos pag dinala mo sa Maynila na ganoon ang mentalidad, nako, kakainin buhay yan dito. So I told him na think twice, no? I have to think twice about him because I think yung mga bagay na importante sa iyo, mga bagay na hindi ko gusto. And he was trying to reach out until this morning and I asked him, ano ba yung tingin mo? Ano yung tingin niya na pinapahiwatig ko sa kanya? And then he verbalized it. And ayun pala, di kung tingin mong makakatulong sa iyo yung mga bagay na gusto ko, di o gawin mo. Kung hindi, di wag mong gawin, walang problema. But at least he knows what I am about. And I think that is coaching also, no? Not just what you know, no, but also letting him know, letting the players know kung ano ang tama at mali para sa iyo. And he decides whether to go with you or not. And that's his role. Salamat sa oras niyo, coaches, ano? Thank you for everyone na sana kahit papaano may naitulong itong mga bagay na ito. To tell you quite honestly, this talk was really inspired by a talk that I went to noong 2011. Now, this was a talk that I went to noong 2011. It was a similar talk, tapos dinagdagan ko na lang ng ilang elemento. And of all people, ano, it was a Nigerian Texan. Taga Texas siya, pero Aprikano siya. So imagine mo, Aprikanong-Aprikano itsura, pero kung magsalita, Texan. No? May twang pa talaga ng mga taga-Texas, mga cowboy na Aprikano. So of all people na magtuturo, what is coaching? Why? Because he is a businessman, business owner. Does not know anything about coaching. But he knows a lot about being a leader of his company. And through that, doon niya chinanel yung kanyang talk about coaching. And this was the inspiration of this talk, ano? An unlikely source, no? But sapul na sapul sa puso ko, which inspired me, motivated me to come up with my own talk about coaching, no? So salamat sa to everyone. Pasensya na kung na took a lot of your time, pero mukhang na nag-enjoy naman ang lahat.
Overtime.
Thank you, coaches. Salamat.
Thank you, coach.
Salamat po, Coach Puti.
Thank you po, coach.
Okay. Boss Ryan, yung mga AIA people will stay?
AIA people, stay ng few minutes para may konting ano tayo, meeting. Konti lang. Okay, thank you, everyone.
Thank you, Coach P.
Next topic natin is
okay, yung Coach Paulo.
May Coach Paulo.
Ayan, nandito.
Next topic natin this Wednesday, Coach Paulo. Don't forget to pre-register.
Thank you.
Thank you po. Mag-ilip na po kami. Salamat po.
Yes.
Thank you po. Speak.
Thank you, Coach.
Thank you, coaches. Thank you, po.
Coach. Thank you. Bye. Thank you.